Some glad morning when this life is over, I fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away, just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away
wondering where we are. We're in New Zealand, the land of the long white cloud. We've decided that we're going to ride bicycles from the north to the south and skateboard along the way. In the name of freedom, self-sufficiency, and because we like a good challenge. I'm gonna enjoy it. I hope you do.
Everyone I love deserves a holiday in the sun almost every day till the lions are off of their backs. A runaway seems are the gate to the Milky Way. Oh, reach for the stars with your brightest gaze. Those who've seen the backs of the cowards have seen how fast they can run. Bullet holes through the walls of the summer. Goddamn, what have we done?
We have assembled here in Auckland to begin this dubious odyssey. A two-week bicycle tour with the pursuit of skateable terrain as our main objective. Together, we plan to ride southwards, navigating the mountain passes and rolling valleys which lie between here and the city of Wellington. This is day one.
We're at Newland Skate Park in Auckland. It's a classic stopover. The rumor is the plans got sent from the States. They were in inches. The local contractors built this place in centimeters.
You gotta be born in the 70s to know how to skate it.
It's rugged.
That end bowl is amazing. Great transition.
Every little town has a skate park and they're all exactly the same because the same guys built them all. But you come across the old bowls, the ones that are all kinked and rugged like this, and those are the fun ones to skate for sure. I don't know anyone that's done it, riding a bike and then trying to skate squats. Flag that, it would be pretty hard. Steer clear of the uphills, steer clear of the gorges. Apart from that, it should be pretty fun.
We had made the decision to pack all our equipment for the trip onto the bicycles. these are our beasts of burden. As we pedal, we are reacquainting ourselves with the various muscles used when piloting these contraptions, for we are amateur cyclists, naive to the challenges we are about to face.
I just went up the whole island uphill.
Oh. The hill doesn't seem to want to ever end.
Apparently it's an easy day, but whoever the hell made those ribs up should be fired. I got it. Come on, Cairo.
Come on, buddy. Did you say it's supposed to be an easy day?
We found it. Little water hole to swim in.
This is amazing. Which is what we need. Like, we need these every 15, 20 kilometers, and then we won't need food or anything. The bottom of this hill, maybe there'll be some asphalt. There's an awful lot of gravel on this trek so far.
What's the use in dying, if I don't know when? What's the use in trying,
On this type of trip, small goals must be set, a destination to work towards, somewhere to be by sundown so we can prepare our food and erect the shelters before giving in to sleep. This evening, we must reach the geothermal phenomenon known simply as Hot Water Beach.
Since 8:30 this morning, we've been riding, and it is 7:39 right now. I've never ridden my bike so much in my entire life. That was tough, man. It was good. It was just long and tough.
Either I'm gonna get used to it, my body's gonna get accustomed, or I'm gonna die every day.
I'm hoping for some smooth sailing, like flat ground, or a little bit of skating at least.
I wonder if we'll skate on this trip.
We're gonna skate.
This doesn't feel like a skate trip.
It just fills back up with sand.
Why can't this be everywhere you go, you know what I mean? Like, I'm kind of sore, I'm just gonna dig a hole somewhere, so.
It feels like a dream. A long bike ride to your own private hot bath. Couldn't ask for anything more, you know?
You know about these things? They mate. And then the woman eats the man's head. Why that should happen, I don't know. Somehow that works for their evolution or something.
Last night was pretty brutal. The wind was like, that's my tent. So then I remembered I had earplugs and I went and got them and then I slept.
This is what's left of my tent right here. I already threw in the garbage. I've had better sleeps, but whatever. It's part of it.
I'm hoping these will help me keep up with John.
I feel like going back to sleep.
We bow our heads southwards and press on. The slower pace of bicycle riding inspires reflection and allows time to appreciate the details so many people drive by unawares every day. Locked in their cars, disconnected from this world, they are merely torsos trapped inside mechanical bubbles. Then the hill climb begins, and the thought of sitting comfortably in one of those motor vehicles, moving with such ease, becomes very tantalizing. Somewhere along this road, we hope to find something to skate.
To the sea,
skating's so much harder when you do a 50-mile bike ride before it.
That was extreme!
Like I said, first try, right, Kenny?
Yeah, always.
Tired and hungry, we keep rolling until we find a suitable spot to pitch our tents for the night. Everyone seems to be thinking the same thing. What have we got ourselves into here?
Morning. A little bathing session in the beautiful river. My body feels a lot better, but my back is a little sore, and the legs. I think that the skateboarding is gonna suffer because of the fatigue from the cycling, but we're still gonna try to do our best.
It's always pretty brutal, like first thing in the morning, just to start with a big hill. Definitely kicks your ass.
One of the conditions of a cycle tour is that you will spend the majority of your time riding uphill. The amount of uphill to downhill terrain may be equal, but it is the speed achievable which sentences you to this almost constant struggle.
The uphill, I don't know, kind of figuring it out, I guess. Figuring out my pace.
I went for my shower this morning. That was the water I drank about 20 minutes ago. Downhills are awesome, but the uphills are so painful.
Going a decent amount of speed during the windy part, and then Dylan and these guys just pass right by me so fast.
Looks like you're gonna get thrown off your bike.
The wind's gnarly.
Some truck comes and that wind hits you going around that corner, you're done.
That hill climb was okay because I expected that to be brutal, and then it wasn't as bad. I think we should expect them all to be as brutal as possible.
Yesterday I thought I was gonna be able to move. I think yesterday was way harder, and then we went and skated, so. Right now I feel good. Hopefully we can skate. You don't want long bike ride, a little tired. Let's check the park.
Look what he did to this can.
I got four of my glasses.
Yeah, his glasses are yard sale.
That's Kenny for you right there.
It's like we've never skated before. We're like mutants. It's not windy.
There we go. Wind, rain. I mean, it can't get any worse, right?
I'm staying, man. That's for you guys.
You want to take a helicopter over here?
It's hard to say. I'm kind of into staying. That looks fun. Silas should go close to each other, close enough so we can smell each other's sweat as we ollie over the hip.
With immense skill and a flaming passion, we flowed through the whip-like lines of this charming and rugged old serpent. But it wasn't long before our pleasure was extinguished. A storm was blowing in.
We're in Frangamata in the caravan park. It's been raining all night. Severe weather warnings put out. Everyone was told to batten down the hatches, tie everything down. So we stayed in these little cabins, which have been quite nice. Now we're just considering whether we're gonna ride it out just now and go over the mountain.
Can't just sit for a whole day and do nothing. We'll all go insane.
Who knows what it'll be like at the top of that mountain, though. Oh, we should probably gather our resources and find out.
Get wet or dry trying?
The eco-friendly shower. No hot showers. Let's go biking in the rain.
Big one to go.
I think I'm at the top of the hill. It says the elevation 236 meters. It was a lot of climbing and a lot of range.
There's a limit to how wet you can get. Once you reach that limit and you're moving, just keep going.
Going downhill is just like flying into a World War II battle.
Skating seems so much easier.
As long as no one dies, it's fine.
Not so bad.
What happened?
I was just coming through here and there's a big truck coming. I guess I hit one of these pylons. And then the next thing I knew, I could just feel my head skating on the ground. Of course, I rolled into the lane of traffic.
The trucks are so bad. You hear them coming and they just kind of brace. And some of them kind of hedge over closer just to mess with you.
Those are really scary vehicles. I don't have anything else to say about it. I survived.
Sometimes you think that it's a little too easy, so you know you have to like step up a little bit, but
he was going, dude.
That was the hardest ride we've had yet. By far. 100 kilometers today, man. These are my hands. I can guarantee you my feet are even worse.
I haven't been in the bath all day, that's for sure.
That's what happens when you lose the oil in your hands, they become sponges.
See, my hands are okay, because, you know, I work for a living, unlike, you know. We're here, we made it. Pretty proud of everyone. Seeing everyone healthy here was kind of cool.
It was pretty rough yesterday. We went from Fenamata to Taranga, where we are right now. I think I'm doing too much biking. I don't even like riding a bicycle.
We went street skating in Taranga after a 100-kilometer ride, and then Cairo decided to try to ollie the biggest gap we could find.
I decided to ollie over a rosemary bush that was in between two car parks.
Some like it hot, you know what I mean? The polite rephrasing of the war crime. Our
fortress, the Russian Southwest. I really think the biking helps out. Like, my ankle feels good, even after jumping down that without my ankle brace. And I guess I'm kind of psyched. It's probably like the biggest thing I've ollied in a couple years.
That just kind of set the tone for the day. I think everyone was like, okay, we can do this. We can skate after.
the longest ride, you know. Haslam, I think, might have broken his toe again. Every time I'm with this guy, he breaks his toe.
We're skating this cement bank, makeshift tranny to bank wall, and when I was testing the rolling, when I tried to pop in to test it, I kind of kicked the floor pretty hard. I was out for like 8 to 9 months with a double fracture on the same toe, and I just got over it, and I just did it again. Starting to really piss me off, but whatever, it happens, so I gotta deal with it. I'm not gonna skate this thing.
I need motivation.
If anybody knows anything about Kenny Anderson, they know that he's a master of the street. I haven't seen Kenny on a vert ramp ever, I don't think.
Like, all these guys aren't, you know, vert skaters. It's just rad seeing them skate it. It's almost like seeing them skate a mini ramp.
I tried to skate street. I was like ready to pass out. And then I don't know, maybe I just woke up more later. But I was. It was fun though. John was flying Scotsman again.
He's gonna do ollie to 50-50 over the channel. Backside air. You blew it. If you were filming, you would have done it.
I'm sitting there on my bike. I'm watching these cars come at me. And I'm thinking, poor suckers. Sitting in their cars. Not experiencing anything, just numb. And then I can tell that they're looking at me like, poor sucker. He's just sitting there on his bike in the rain. What a loser. But you know what? I'm not a loser.
This old park is really good. I think that people aren't ready for these type of sculptures. Skateboarding hasn't reached the level that it needs to be in order to really make use of these obstacles.
An interview, or is this just a cutaway shot?
Yeah, cutaway.
I told him to slow down, so he didn't.
Well, now all I have to do is concentrate on my biking, because skating's not happening, so I think it's a new leap. I'm gonna try not to complain once for the rest of the trip. I can't feel my legs. I think they're numb. Oh yeah!
Today? Rotorua? I have no idea where we're going.
I think we're going to Rotorua.
Turning inland for the first time, we seem to reach a physical and mental barrier. At this point, most of us choose to take a relaxed approach and wait for our second wind. Except for one. Is it an act of will, or is he some kind of man-machine?
We love it, it was awesome! Yeah! Right?
That's right.
That's why we're here, man! Hey? Yeah! We'll be right back.
Today was a hard day. Everyone's energy levels were low. Now, I know that Cairo was at a low point. He said he was ready to just ghost ride his bike into the ditch and give up. But no one's gonna give up. Everyone's just gonna power through. Even Keegan was feeling the burn today. The man with the thighs and buns of steel. And hopefully we'll have a mellow day tomorrow. You know, things will start to pick up. We'll get a second wind. Power down to wherever it is this road's taking us. It's never an easy day.
I don't exist.
Every day is a hard day.
No matter what. No matter what.
You can only ask for headwind. Tailwind? I'd be asking for too much.
Skating makes your body feel really weird. It's like loose in some places and tight in others. It's terrible. Tries. Nose grind, nollie, turn to lip slide, a half cap to board slide. Seven kind of. One more. I can still do 10 tricks.
Half cap crooks. That's a sick one. Seems we are being rewarded for the hard work. Our resilience to the physical demands of this mission has increased, and the sense of achievement has come to outshine the intense pain and exhaustion.
That was the best thing right there.
Yeah.
I know, I finally felt good that last part. There was no wind in my face.
Downhill, beautiful view.
Is that what you're talking about? Downhill. Last night we had our first night ride. We rode about 35 kilometers by the moonlight, and it was pretty epic. It was really nice and it was quiet. It was one of the better times of my life, I think. Strangely, riding a bicycle at night in farmland. And then we had a payoff. Thank you.
amazing way to wake up. Just slide out of your tent and slip into the hot spring.
I slept over there under that tree.
Apparently you're not supposed to go underwater because of all the algae and stuff in there.
You are the dead man.
Revitalized by thermal waters from deep between the bosoms of Mother Earth, we set out once again. Today, we are in good spirits, and there is increased confidence all around. However, there comes a point somewhere on the road when the wind penetrates you with its howling loneliness. The rider is forced into the here and now and must dig deep within. Increment by increment, we make progress, harmonizing with our bicycles. Even the persistent headwind is now a welcome challenge, rather than a sadistic device of torture.
Strongest headwinds yet. It's been good though, we've been sticking in a group, which I guess in cycling is called a peloton. And the guy in front takes the brunt of it, and then you just shift back to front, back to front.
Against the wind, but we're just pacing, and you're just pushing against the wind. And then starting off in the hot springs, you can't beat that, so nothing too much to complain about.
So we're cycling down the road, and we just see smoke. And we think, uh-oh, smoke. So we have a look, and all it is smoke. Welcome to Talpo.
If I'm skating a handrail, I never ollie the stairs first. So I just throw my carcass a few times to see if I can clear the whole thing without twisting my ankle.
This ground sucks!
Then try to make the board make contact, not with me on the board. And then eventually get me and the board to stay connected on the obstacle. I like the spot. It's a handrail and then it's got a little gap before it. It's our last day of cycling, but we still have a few more days in the trip. And we got a fallen soldier, Kenny. Got hit by a car yesterday, and he can't make the last day with us, which sucks.
You know, you make it this whole way, and that's kind of what's pushing you. And here I am the last day with a little splint, and I can't ride. It's pretty upsetting.
I think Kenny's faking, because he just couldn't handle the pressure of being around these amazing gentlemen and incredible athletes.
Final stretch, 50K around Lake Taupo towards what is now known as Mordor.
Sad that we're not going to be riding anymore. I'm kind of getting used to this. It's pretty fun. It's just a fun way of living, camping and rolling around on bicycles.
All in all, I'm pretty excited that we've done this. I feel like I've biked more in the last 10 days than I've biked my whole life.
Gave me a lot more respect for bike riders, for sure. I'm gonna give them a lot more room when I drive around them.
It was a beautiful ride along Lake Taupo. Felt like everyone had that sense that this was the last day, so most of us were just charging. I believe the ride was approximately 50 kilometers, and it seemed like we did it really quickly.
We've arrived in Tarangi, which is our end of cycling spot. I think we did really good for a bunch of dudes that don't ride bikes very often, so it's a good start.
We've only made it half of what we thought we might do in the allotted time period. So that's fair enough.
I'm happy that I did 500 kilometers, man. That's pretty impressive to me.
Pretty stoked on what we did, but I don't really want to leave New Zealand. I just wanted to keep going.
This guy's going to Auckland right now.
Look at him go.
He'll get there in like an hour.
Kind of how Chris rides.
That was how I ride. I don't think I'll ever ride my bike again, to be honest.
By Tarangi, we had pedaled more than 500 kilometers. It had taken us 10 days. We had ridden over mountains, battling the elements. We had performed skateboard maneuvers on many structures, some enchanting and some repellent. Along the way, we had been reminded of the laws of nature and the limits they impose. We had been forced by eager truck drivers and deranged bogans to consider the balance between life and death. We had learned to see nature's puzzles rather than its problems. And that rocks don't always sink, sometimes they float. But enough of this rubbish, because now we have only one choice, which is no choice. We have to get to our final destination, the city of Wellington.
Nice not having panniers.
Silas wants to skate the bank.
Oh,
trick, that was it. Let's go. You get the photo?
My bike.
You guys didn't sign the contract with Fuel TV. We're required to do both summits. We have to do the volcano. What was that? Article 15-4. And then 15-5 was we had to go up the top of Mount Doom.
I think walking is a lot harder than cycling.